This video is for pre-calculus unit 10 conic sections. We are still dealing with parabolas. So the very first thing we're going to do in this example is look at our equation. Notice right away that x is equal to 112 times y plus 4 squared minus 1. That means that we have a situation in which x is equal to a positive a because there's no sign in front of 112. And that's going to be y minus h, oh, sorry, k. And then squared plus h. There we go. All right, sorry, got distracted. Okay, so having said that, we need to recognize that because the 112th is positive, this is going to open to the right. So we'll have an axis of symmetry, of course, that's going to be a horizontal line this time. So let's start by finding our vertex. Now, just because these are in a different position because of this and this, we still put the x value or the h value first because how we graph on the coordinate plane won't change. It's always going to be xy. So we've got negative 1, negative 4. This value behaves inside the parentheses the same way it does every time we have something in parentheses. Okay, so our axis of symmetry this time is going to be y equals negative 4 because y is negative 4 up here. And I'm going to find p, so 1 over 4 times a, which is 1 over 12. So that gives me 4 over 1 times 1 over 12. This reduces. So I've got 1 over 1 third, which gives me 3. Excellent. Now we're going to find the absolute value of 1 over a, so that's just 1 over 1 12th, and that, of course, is 12. Now we're ready to graph. We are going to find these values after we graph or as we graph. So we're going to start with the vertex first. So negative 1, negative 4, right there. The axis of symmetry is going to be right here at y equals negative 4. We are going to, since we have a situation where the parabola opens right, that means the vertex being right here, the focus or the focal point will be to the right of that, and it'll be 3 to the right because the p is 3 here. So there's the focus right there. And the directrix, The focal point is 2, negative 4. And then the directrix is going to be on the other side of the vertex by 3. So remember, the directrix is a line perpendicular to the axis of symmetry. So this time it's going to be x equals negative 4. And, of course, we need to use our focal cord length to get the endpoints of our focal cord. So it goes through the focus, and it's 12 long. So that means 6 on either side of the focal point right here. So that's how we graph our parabola. I have graphed much better than that. That's not quite rounded there, but you get the idea. Okay, so the endpoints, this one right here is positive 2, positive 2. This one here is positive 2, negative 10, right down there. Okay, awesome. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Let's look at number 4. This time we've got x again, but now a is negative. That means that we are going to be opening to the left. Okay, the axis of symmetry will be a horizontal line again, and let's start with our vertex. So remember, this is my x value, this is my y value, so it's going to be a negative 1 because this is positive. And we are going to find our axis of symmetry. It is going to be y equals negative 1. Let's find p. So P is going to be 1 over 4 times 1 over 16, which gives me, that reduces. So I get 1 over 1 over 4, which is 4. And then, of course, we want to find the absolute value of 1 over A, which is 1 over 1 16th, which gives me 16. So the focal chord length is 16. We are going to find these points as we graph. So we'll start with our vertex again, negative 3, negative 1. There's my vertex. And this time, since the parabola is opening left, I know that I'm going to have the focus to the left of this by 4. There's the focus. And the directrix will be 4 to the right. So there's the directrix right there. That's going to be x equals 1. And then, of course, I forgot the axis of symmetry. Of course I did. And then, of course, we need to draw in our focal chord. So it's 16. So through the focus, that means 8 to the above it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 right there. And below it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 right here. Okay, so those ordered pairs are going to be negative 7, positive 7. Make sure I can count right, because, you know, that's tricky sometimes for me, apparently. And then a negative 7, negative 9. Okay, groovy. And then, of course, we use those to guide our parabola. That was a horrible parabola, Miss Griggs. Horrible. But you get the idea. Easy peasy.